Today on HakTip, more on using the find command. And this HakTip is brought to you by Eero. Welcome to HakTip, the show where we break down concepts, tools, and techniques for hackers, gurus, and IT ninjas. I'm your host, Shannon Morris, and today we are talking about finding things. So last week we started going into detail on all the different ways that you can use find commands to search for files, information about files, and more. Now this week I'm going to finish up that command with more options that can be super handy for most scenarios. And of course, as usual, if you use this command in some really interesting way, you can leave your comments below because I love sharing all of the awesome ways that you can use the Linux terminal with our entire community. So first off, we are going to talk about the and the or commands. So these are tack A and tack O. Adding a tack A to your command will allow you to search for a file or multiple files with more than one criteria. So for example, and I'll turn to my computer, I could search for find.tacname, and I'll use techthing*.txt as my usual example by itself, and that lists out any techthing.txt files with that wildcard. But if I do that same command and then at the end, I'm going to add tack A, tack size, and plus 14K, for example, that is going to give me only the files that are over that 14 kilobytes as well as techthing wildcard.txt in the name. Now, if I change that tack A to a tack O, so I'll just erase back here, and I pressed up to use my previous command. Now that gives me a whole lot more output. So you will see that find now searches for files named techthing-wildcard.txt, or it also includes files that are over 14 kilobytes in size. Now I get a pretty long list, obviously. It seems a little bit complicated. Now for an even more complicated command to go with it. So say I want to find every single file that is 8 kilobytes or larger, but not one's called techthing, so I don't want to include any of my files with the word techthing in it, for example. I could type in, and I'll go ahead and clear this so it's not all a bunch of garbledygook in there, find period, and I'm going to backslash this first off, open parentheses, space tack size, and I'm going to look for things that are over 8 kilobytes, tack O, anything that is also or 8 kilobytes in size. So that means anything over 8 kilobytes, including that size 8 kilobytes. A space, and then I'm going to close out that parentheses right there. And I am not going to include tack name, put it in quotes, techthing*.txt, and close those quotes. And hit enter. Okay, so this time, it's also still very long, but I will break it down for you. So first off, if I just search for any files of those sizes, it will find everything, including the techthing files. So I wanted to omit those techthing files, and in order to do that, I added that exclamation mark, then the additional option. So anything after that exclamation mark will not be included. I'm also going to put the two size options inside of those parentheses, like you can see here, if I can highlight that correctly. There we go. And the backslashes before each of those parentheses, make sure that the shell doesn't misinterpret them as being a part of that search. So they are not included, they are just closing in that command. You also need to put a space before the parentheses and your search option so that the parentheses are not included again. So that's pretty much everything on how you can search different sizes and use that and or command, but we have a little bit more to share on the find command right after this break. When you are looking to improve your wireless network, making sure your entire home has a strong signal is a must, and that is where Eero comes in. They are launching their very first second generation mesh Wi-Fi system that comes with one Eero and 1-2 beacons. And these are mesh access points. They are not extenders. They are smaller. They also plug into an outlet. They have an ambient nightlight, and they are more powerful than the originals. But of course, if you already have the original, Eero has you covered as well. These babies are backwards compatible available and they can be purchased separately. Systems start at $399 for all three components together, but if you want to just buy one beacon, you can totally do that as well. You can, and they're cheaper than the originals at $149 each. We've gotten a chance to test these out in the warehouse where our wireless usually does not reach from one end to another. The Eero Mesh does a really great job of fixing that headache, and it gives me the speeds that I pay for from my ISP, plus it was really easy to set up and it's also very reliable. So Eero is also announcing the Eero Plus subscription, which includes advanced network security monitoring, supplementing the features that are already built in that you get for free with the device, and they also include content filtering, which is really great for houses with kids. And with any system, you get automatic updates, two-factor authentication for the admin access, and Eero's backing with a bug bounty program and third-party audits. We've got a coupon code for you too. For free overnight shipping to the US or Canada, you can visit Eero.com and at checkout select overnight shipping and then enter HakTip to make it free. Check it out and learn more at Eero.com. We are now back with the find command. Now I want to go into a little bit more detail about that little exclamation mark that I used, which is the omit option. We talked about it a little bit before. The nice thing is that you can also use this expression for options that are inside parentheses. So for example, I can type in find period exclamation mark, and then I will use a backslash parentheses space, and I'm gonna look for, not C's, size. Plus 8K, so over kilobytes, over 8 kilobytes, and then attack O, including the size, 8 kilobytes, and close that out with another backslash, close parentheses, tech name, and we're looking for tech thing, wildcard.txt again, and hit enter. It's telling me permission denied. Don't worry about that, but it did find the correct thing, which is techthing short 001.txt, which is the only txt file with techthing in the name that is less than 8 kilobytes. So it totally works in that case, and it is only going to find that one file. Another thing to add with find, you can always add multiple options in between those parentheses, not just one or two. And to take find a little bit of a step further, you can also execute commands on any files that find finds. So for example, I could rename all of my .txt files to end with uppercase.txt and vice versa. So to do this, I would type in, and for this one, I'm just gonna hit up a couple times because I've already run this a few times on my computer. And in this case, I have lowercase.txts and I want to change them to uppercase. So I'll write txt right there and change this to txt and put this in uppercase like that. And then I hit enter and it should change them all into uppercase txt. There we go. So I now have a bunch of uppercase text files as opposed to lowercase text ones. So this change is going to take effect immediately and it will change those lowercase all the way to uppercase. This can be really handy since find is case sensitive, so sometimes you might run into problems with that. So I'm going to go ahead and break down that command because it is a little bit intensive. So first off, find looks universally right here for the name. And those are going to be anything ending in star.txt, and that's lowercase txt, and I put that in quotes. Then it executes the rename option right here on txt. Now the next thing it does is S stands for substitute. So I'm substituting lowercase txts to uppercase txts. And then that is going to be globally on the entire computer. The brackets over here represent each file that must be included, which is all of them. And then we use the backslash semicolon. So that will escape the semicolon. The semicolon ends the execute command, and escaping it allows it to not be misunderstood as its own character in find. So now I'm just gonna reverse that command back to what I had originally put in here, like so. And hit enter, and then everything should go back to lowercase. I actually just prefer lowercase because it's less typing for me. Now, the last thing to share about find is using the fprint option. So this is going to pass the output of a file that you choose or create, or I should say to a file. So I'm going to type in find.tacname, and again, I'm going to look for that star.txt for any txt files, and I'll type in fprint, and I'm going to put all of those printouts in a test file dot .txt document. And actually, first off, I wanna change my directory, so I'm just gonna erase this real quick and change directory over to my snubstuff test folder. Okay, so now I'll type that in. There we go. So if I go over here and click on test file, you'll see that it has all of my text documents out in a test file. And I could also just cat that too. So testfile.txt, and then it's written out into my Linux terminal. Yay, so that was easy. Okay, that is about it for the find command. Be sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel. It's youtube.com/hack5, and hit that little like button if you got some good information out of today's episode. Until then, I want to hear your feedback. Comment below and tell me about your favorite commands or options, and be sure to check out our sister show, which is Hack5, for more great stuff just like this. And I'll be there reminding you to trust your technolest.